Hello everyone. Over the past 3 years of me being a mentor and teacher for students preparing for UPSC Civil Services exam, the one thing that I've heard the most is they find it extremely challenging to clear the prelims exam itself, right? And for no wrong reasons, prelims exam is considered to be one of the toughest stages to clear for two reasons. Number one is the selection ratio. Out of the 5-6 lakh people who appear in the exam every year, only around 8 to 10,000 people clear it. That makes the selection ratio at meager 2%, right? Number one. Number two, another problem is that there is only one paper that matters to score, basically, CSAT being qualifying, and you have only 2 hours to do everything right on that day under extreme stress, under extreme pressure. And if you miss out on something, your entire year is wasted. This is unlike mains exam, where there are 7 papers which are marked, and even if you screw up one of the paper, you still have 6 paper to salvage the situation, right? So there are plenty of you out there who have not been able to clear prelims in the past couple of years and have done everything in their power till now to make sure that they clear it, but still have not managed to clear it, right? They have gone through different test series, they have gone through different books, they have gone through different classroom programs also, multiple crash course programs that comes into play before the prelims exam. Now, today I'm here to give you a solution, especially when these we have been given 4 additional months to prepare or to mend all our mistakes, fill all our gaps that have been there in the past. And unfortunately, these 4 months also means that the competition is going to be even more tougher this year. So this is the time when we have to ensure, especially people, especially aspirants, first of all, who are first timers and wants to clear it in this first attempt itself, and candidates who have not been able to clear the exam in the past couple of years, or candidates who might have cleared the exam once, prelims once, but they still are not sure if it was actually, if they will be able to do it again, and maybe it was a fluke last time. Right, so you such candidates should ensure that they do not leave any stone unturned over the next 4 months, right? And only then they can ensure that they will clear the exam. No. The prime reason that people have not been able to clear prelims in their first or second or third attempt is that they do not understand where they are going wrong. They are not able to figure out what are the weaknesses that they have, which is stopping them from clearing the prelims. They always come very close. Maybe if 100 is the cutoff, they always come to 96, 97, 98, even 99, and they tap out of the exam, unfortunately, and they have to repeat the entire process all over again, which is extremely frustrating, right? So today, this test series, which is being launched by me, is primarily focused on addressing all these problems and how to make sure that we clear the exam this year itself. The test series will entirely focus on one thing and one thing only: to find out your problems, find out your weaknesses, and try to fix them before the exam. Right? The test series will focus on extremely detailed diagnosis, and it will be 100% mentor supported, who will help you figure out these problems, who will help you understand these problems, who will help you find trends in your problems that you have not been able to figure out so far, and will help you with strategies, will help you with methods how to fix these problems, right? Now, so during the prelims preparation, there are only 2 steps that everyone has to do, all the aspirants have to do. So one is read and revise. Whatever you're reading, everybody does the same. Aapko basic standard NCERT books, your reference books, or the class notes that you have to read. You read and you keep revising them, right? And second is the test taking strategy, the test that you have to take. Then you have to analyze your performance in the test, and finally you have to improve based on that. Theek hai? But unfortunately, what has happened in the past couple of years, the test taking strategy has gone haywire. What has happened is there has been an immense emphasis on the score that everybody achieves during the test. Hum continuously we take like 50, 60, 100, even 150, 200 tests, right? We keep going through one test after the other on a daily basis, and the only focus that we have is kitna score ban raha hai. You might be scoring 90, 100, 110, but the score is of no value until and unless you understand wo score aaya kaise. Theek hai? There is always a possibility after preparing for a couple of years that you are making guesswork here. And in a lot of test series, it also becomes very easy to guess, because you understand the idea ki kaise aap paper set kar rahe hain, ठीक है, दिस हैज बीन सीन. सो वी आर हैप्पी कि कितना स्कोर बन रहा है, 110 115 बन रहा है, वी आर हैप्पी. वी डू नॉट गो टू द रूट कॉज कि वो स्कोर आ कैसे रहा है, राइट. वी हैव टू वेरी क्लियरली अंडरस्टैंड वो स्कोर नॉलेज से आ रहा है और वो स्कोर गेस्टवर्क से आ रहा है. इफ इट इज थ्रू नॉलेज नथिंग बेटर देन दैट, बट इफ इट इज थ्रू गेस्टवर्क, नाउ द गेस्टवर्क माइट बी वर्किंग टूडे बट इट मे और मे नॉट वर्क ऑन द डी डे. तब क्या करोगे अगर वहां पर नहीं हुआ? There is a lot of panic, there is a lot of stress during that exam 2 hours, and if the guesswork does not work, your entire year's worth of preparation is wasted. You have to do everything all over again. To come out of this cycle, what do you have to do? You have to read and revise better. ठीक है, जितना अच्छे से पढ़ोगे, जितना अच्छे से revise करोगे, you will have a better understanding, better grasp of things. And how do you ensure that you have read and revised better? उसके लिए आपको कंटिन्यूअसली टेस्ट करना है. टेस्ट तो हम कर रहे हैं बट जस्ट बाय टेकिंग द टेस्ट इट डज नॉट हेल्प. यू विल हैव टू टेस्ट एंड देन यू विल हैव टू गो एंड एनालाइज व्हाट काइंड ऑफ मिस्टेक्स यू हैव मेड. इफ यू हैव मेड एनी मिस्टेक्स, सी इन एवरी टेस्ट दैट यू टेक मे बी यू आर एबल टू डू 60, 65, 70, 75 क्वेश्चंस. देयर आर स्टिल 25 क्वेश्चंस, देयर आर स्टिल सम क्वेश्चंस दैट यू विल गेट रॉन्ग आल्सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम दोस 25 क्वेश्चंस. सो यू हैव टू गो एंड चेक कि वो क्वेश्चंस गलत कहां हो रहे हैं. ठीक है, सो इन द एनालिसिस वंस यू figure out कि आपके question किस area में गलत हो रहे हैं, within see when you take a full length test you have to see what subject is weak, when you take a subject test you have to see what particular area in that subject is weak, and in every subject also you have to also understand that if you are getting factual questions wrong or conceptual questions wrong, कि factual attention में problem है या conceptual understanding ही नहीं है. ठीक है, so a test is supposed to do all this. A test is supposed to help you decipher all these problems in your preparation. And once you have this analysis at hand, let's say mera polity weak hai or eco weak hai, economics, right? Within polity, now you will check maybe mera parliament weak hai, theek hai? Ya economics mein mera national income hi weak hai, right? Now within national income, you will check facts yaad hai ya nahi hai ya concepts weak hai. So this is the level of understanding that you have to develop through your analysis, and once you know the areas, only then you can improve, right? You cannot be doing the same thing over and over again. हम लक्ष्मीकांत खोल के बैठ जाते हैं. We start revising from chapter 1 to whatever chapter is there at the end, and unfortunately, what happens till the time you reach a particular chapter that actually needed your attention, आप तब तक bore हो गए हो तो revision से. Or you just skim through that chapter, thinking कि सब कुछ तो आता ही है, सब कुछ तो पढ़ ही रखा है एक बार, right? But when you actually take the test, if you analyze properly, you will realize कि यार ये area weak रह गया था. हर बार मैं revision में भी गड़बड़ कर देता हूँ या कर देती हूँ. I always miss out on this. And next time when I revise, I will first focus on improving this, and then I will revise the other things. ऐसा नहीं कि बाकी चीजें रिवाइज नहीं करनी है, बट आई विल गिव मोर एम्फेसिस ऑन दिस. सिमिलरली ओवर हियर, व्हाइल यू कीप डूइंग नेशनल इनकम, यू कीप गोइंग फ्लिपिंग थ्रू द पेजेस ऑफ योर नोट, यू कीप फ्लिपिंग थ्रू द पेजेस ऑफ योर बुक, व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू डू, व्हाइल मे बी यू आर एबल टू रिटेन द फैक्ट्स, शायद कॉन्सेप्चुअल प्रॉब्लम ही है, बहुत ज्यादा कॉन्सेप्चुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग ही क्लियर नहीं है. और मे बी व्हाइल यू हैव टेकन अ क्लास, कॉन्सेप्ट्स तो क्लियर हो गए बट फैक्ट्स याद रखने में दिक्कत हो रही है. जब वो ट्रेंड वगैरह के क्वेश्चन आते हैं, यू आर नॉट एबल टू सॉल्व देम प्रॉपरली. सो ऑल दिस इज सपोज टू बी डन थ्रू द टेस्ट. ठीक है, नाउ वेयर डज द प्रॉब्लम लाइज? एस्पिरेंट्स जो करते हैं, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दे ओनली फोकस ऑन टेस्ट टेकिंग. टेस्ट टेकिंग की भैया इतने सारे टेस्ट कर लिए हैं, आई विल रिवाइज सम टाइम इन द फ्यूचर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल 100-150 टेस्ट करके रिविजन भी नहीं होता है. देन इवन इफ दे आर एबल टू रिवाइज, दे फोकस ऑन मेरे कितना रेगुलर स्कोर आ रहा है. 90-100 आ रहा है तो आई एम ओके, ऑल्दो इट मे नॉट हेल्प. यहां पे अगर 120 आएगा तब जाके शायद एग्जाम हॉल में 110 या 105 आएगा. बट 120 कब आएगा? जब आप ये सब इंप्रूव करेंगे. ठीक है, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अ लॉट ऑफ यू, ऑलमोस्ट 70% ऑफ यू डोंट इवन एनालाइज व्हाट इज गोइंग रॉन्ग. नेक्स्ट कम्स द लॉट हु ट्राइज टू एनालाइज. नाउ इन दैट एनालिसिस प्रोसेस आइदर यू स्पेंड एंटायर डे, 5-6 घंटे लग जाते हैं. लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स कम बैक एंड टेल मी दिस कि सर आपने बोला था एनालाइज करना है, बट वी एंड अप स्पेंडिंग द एंटायर डे इन एनालिसिस ओनली. And once they analyze, they are not able to understand उस analysis को use कैसे कर रहे. ठीक है, that is another problem. So once this does not, if this does not happen, there is no way you can improve. ठीक है, so the focus has to be on the diagnosis of the problem, the focus has to be on the analysis part properly and how to use that analysis better. If you are not able to figure out how to use it, find help. ठीक है, that is the point that I am trying to make here. Also understand that there is an immense importance of diagnostics in the test taking process, without which test taking does not mean anything. In my classroom also, a lot of students who are watching this video, if you are from my classroom, I have focused on detailed diagnosis even in my classroom test that I take, right? So uska bahut zaruri hai karna, otherwise there is no point of taking a test, because you will still stand at the same point. आप वहीं पे खड़े रहेंगे जहां पिछले टेस्ट में थे, जहां उससे पिछले टेस्ट में थे, जहां उससे पिछले टेस्ट में थे. यू हैव टू इंप्रूव. हाउ डू यू इंप्रूव? यू फिगर आउट योर प्रॉब्लम्स. अदरवाइज देयर इज नो रीजन दैट यू कैन इंप्रूव. आप एक ही चीज बार बार करते रहेंगे, नहीं होगा उससे, राइट? सो इन द टेस्ट सीरीज, अनदर प्रॉब्लम दैट इज देयर इज द टेस्ट सीरीज इज मेड वंस एंड फॉर ऑल. एक सेट ऑफ टेस्ट बन जाते हैं एंड एवरी स्टूडेंट हैज टू मेक डू विद दैट. Now consider a situation wherein a particular candidate is weak in economics and maybe not so weak in polity or history or other subject, or maybe another student is weak in history but not in the other subjects. Okay? So for that particular candidate, it should be a point of importance that he or she has to practice more on that particular weak area. For example, student 1 should practice more on economics, student 2 should practice more on history. But the test series that are present in the market, unfortunately, they have only a fixed number of tests, जो सबके लिए एक बराबर हैं. तो अगर दो टेस्ट हिस्ट्री के हैं, दो टेस्ट पॉलिटी के हैं, दो टेस्ट इकोनॉमिक्स के हैं, इट डज नॉट मैटर, इट डज नॉट टेक इन टू अकाउंट कि आप किस एरिया में वीक हैं, है ना, हम बताएंगे आपको क्या करना है. नहीं, ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए. दिस वन साइज फिट्स ऑल अप्रोच डज नॉट रियली हेल्प एवरी एस्पिरेंट, एंड दैट इज अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट रीजन दैट यू आर नॉट एबल टू क्लियर इट. अनफॉर्चुनेटली क्या होता है, इफ यू थिंक यू आर वीक इन हिस्ट्री, इफ यू थिंक यू आर वीक इन इकोनॉमिक्स, एक तो टेस्ट सीरीज आपकी खत्म हो जाती है, देन यू गो एंड लुक फॉर अनदर टेस्ट फ्रॉम अनदर टेस्ट सीरीज बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू प्रैक्टिस मोर. बट द प्रॉब्लम देयर इज दैट इन अनदर टेस्ट सीरीज द एंटायर पेपर सेटिंग वुड बी इन अ डिफरेंट मैनर एंड यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू फिगर आउट कहां गड़बड़ थी. पहले पेपर सेट में कुछ और ही प्रॉब्लम सामने आ रही थी, दूसरे पेपर सेट में कुछ और प्रॉब्लम सामने आ गई, राइट? सो दैट डज नॉट रियली हेल्प. So, a test series should also be designed in such a way that it adapts to the students and not vice versa. Students should not have to adapt to a test series, but the test series should adapt to the students. Now, keeping all this in mind, and now that we have additional 4 months, this is like a golden opportunity wherein you can improve upon all your preparation drastically and make sure that you have a seat in your mains exam. I am releasing a test series today which will keep in mind all these problems. First of all, it will have a detailed diagnosis, right, of every test that you take, which will keep in mind all these levels and tell you exactly what area are you weak in, to what level are you weak in that area. For example, again, agar hum polity ki baat kare, so maybe in parliament you are able to solve easy questions, but whenever it comes to moderate or difficult questions, you are not able to solve them. That means aapne padha to hai but superficially padha hai, and you need to go back to that chapter and read it in depth. I will give you that analysis इन अ डिटेल्ड रिपोर्ट कार्ड कि आप इजी क्वेश्चन कर पा रहे हैं बट डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन नहीं कर पा रहे हैं. इन सम एरियाज मे बी यू आर एबल टू डू डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन बट व्हेन इट कम्स टू इजी क्वेश्चन यू आर गेटिंग इट रॉन्ग. आई विल अगेन हाईलाइट दैट इन द टेस्ट रिपोर्ट शोइंग दैट वाइल यू हैव फोकस्ड ऑन द डिफिकल्ट पार्ट यू हैव बिकम वेरी कैलस ओवर टाइम व्हेन इट कम्स टू इजी पार्ट एंड रिवाइज करते हुए यू आर जस्ट स्किमिंग थ्रू दैट इजी पार्ट एंड नाउ यू हैव फॉरगॉटन दैट. At the same time, I will also highlight if you are wrong in factual area, if you are wrong in conceptual area, if you need a conceptual understanding, or if you need to revise further for remembering the facts better. Okay? So this will come to the diagnostic part. Now, as I said, a lot of you are not able to understand the diagnosis or the analysis. So this test series comes with 100% unlimited mentorship support. And I will personally mentor all of you along with one more mentor who has a stellar record of clearing all the prelims exam with a score of over 125 every time, right? So that person also understands very clearly what goes wrong when students are not able to clear the prelims. So we will personally mentor you, and this mentorship will be available over call, unfortunately, due to coronavirus. Otherwise, it would have been a personal thing, personal interaction. But this will be available all day, every day till your exam, and we will help you figure out your problems. We will help you find trends in the mistakes that you make over time. We will help you if you are making casual mistakes, if you are making silly mistakes, right? And we will try to help you work on them. We will suggest you strategy how to improve upon those weaknesses, so that next time when you take a test, you definitely score better. right? And number three, as I said, this test series is the first of its kind wherein it will actually adapt to every single aspirant. While there will be two tests, level 1 and level 2, which will be common for all because that is required to understand the basic level of preparation for everyone. Now, after those two tests, if there is somebody who is weak in a particular subject, he or she will get a specifically designed test paper at a level 3, which will highlight what all problems that were faced by that particular candidate in the previous two tests, and we will check if those problems have been resolved or not, right? So this is the first of a kind test series that has been launched, that will be launched from 1st of July, which will actually adapt to the student requirement instead of student having to adapt to the test series. Now, some other details about the test series. The schedule of the test series will be such that you will get ample time to prepare every subject starting from history 1st of July. You will get 15 days to revise your history, 10 days for polity, 12 days for economics, again 10 days for geography, 10 days for environment and science and technology. At the same time, you will get 15 days each for covering 3 months of current affairs. Every 15 days there will be a current affairs based test which will cover 3 months, designated 3 months, and this test series is going to cover 16 months of current affairs from May 2019 to August 31st, 2020. At the same time, once all this is done, there will be 5 tests which will be full length in nature that will happen towards the end, from August end till September 21st. You will be given a week every time to revise everything that you have to revise based on the analysis that we will do over the 2 months of the preparation and improve upon every area that has been weak for you during your preparation, right? So you can see the schedule on the side of the screen, and you can also go and refer to the detailed brochure. Now, why is this test series starting in July and not in June? Because as I also recommended, that June should be focused and spent on preparation of your mains area and improving upon your mains area. And July is the time when people should go ahead and prepare for prelims, especially people who are first timers and wants to clear this exam in the very first attempt, people who have been struggling with clearing prelims, 2-3 saal se prepare kar rahe hain, prelims clear nahi ho raha hai, or people who have cleared prelims once but they are not sure ki pichli baar shayad fluke ho gaya tha, but abhi bhi guarantee nahi hai ki is baar prelims clear hoga. Prelims has been very indeterminate also in the past couple of years. Kisi bhi type ke question aa jate hain, but if you analyze, there is a trend of things. There is still 65 to 70 questions that are easily doable, and our job in this test series is to ensure that you are well prepared to capture those 65 or 70 questions that are required to clear this exam. Understand very clearly that this additional 4 months, while has come as a boon for a lot of you, it will also make it more difficult to compete. It will also increase the competition to certain extent, because all of you have almost prepared everything and now you have 4 more months to go through everything once all over again. That is why I also mentioned that 15 days for history has been given for you to revise, not to prepare now, because it is expected that all of you have already read things once or twice, and now it is time to fix the mistakes or highlight the mistakes first, fix them while revising things properly. So 15 days are enough for the entire history, 10 days for polity, 12 days for economics. Okay. So these people should focus completely on prelims from July or mid-July, as and when they want to start. At the same time, the areas has been designed in such a way that while preparing or while revising, you can also take your mains test. Taki thoda bahut mains ki answer writing practice bhi hoti rahe. Okay. Now, since it is one-to-one mentorship program, there are only limited seats. There will be 200 seats in this test series, out of which 35-40 has already been filled before the launch of this test series itself. So if you are interested in joining the test series, feel free to contact on the number that will be displayed on the screen right now, and go through the brochure that is available in the description, the link to which is available in the description, and feel free to contact for any further detail that you want to. Thank you very much. I hope the test series will help you guys. In fact, I will try to ensure that everybody who is joining the test series, we work day and night tirelessly with you guys to make sure that you at least have a seat in your mains exam this year. Thank you very much.